Welcome to another edition of Fashion Council. I'm being joined again by Mike Stevens, our expert on HR and employment issues for the fashion industry.
Hey, Tony.
So today we're going to talk about social media and your employees and the NLRB. There's been a lot of press lately about companies wanting to restrict what their employees say on Facebook, on Twitter, and the like. But they've gotten in a lot of trouble for trying to regulate this, right?
They sure have. The National Labor Relations Board has made this an important issue with the current members of the board. Many fashion companies mistakenly believe that the National Labor Relations Act only applies to unionized workforces. That's not true. It gives every employee, whether they're unionized or not, the right to engage in what's called protected concerted activity. So, for example, if someone is complaining on social media about their supervisor or about their terms and conditions of employment, and they're talking to other employees or inducing other employees to complain about the supervisor, that's protected concerted activity. If a company terminates employees because of that, it can be found liable, just like Betty Page was found liable in a recent case before the NLRB.
Interesting. So what if I want to fire my employee because they disclosed something they shouldn't? They posted their paycheck on there. They told a trade secret, hey, our new shoe design is going to have this type of feature. Can I do that?
Well, there are limits. The easy answer is it depends. In order for the conduct to be covered by the NLRA, it has to be protected and concerted. It's concerted if the employee is acting with or on the authority of other employees or calling other employees to action. It's protected as long as it is not malicious or as long as it is not otherwise inappropriate. So if the employee is issuing threats of violence or using profanity or disclosing confidential information or doing other things that is inappropriate, it's not considered protected concerted activity.
So let me give you some hard questions, Mike. So let's assume I'm a fashion house. I have a whole line of clothing coming out. And I've spent a lot of time advertising this new line. And I've put a lot of money into developing this new line. But one of the primary designers I have didn't get one of his products into the line that he thought he should. So he goes on Twitter and talks about how bad the whole line is as a whole. Is this somebody I could fire for that?
Probably, Tony. It's an individualized gripe, in my opinion. They're not calling other employees into action. He's not discussing terms and conditions of employment. He's arguably disclosing confidential information, trade secret information. So as long as you're treating that employee the same way you would treat any other employee and there are no concerns about discrimination, I think he could fire that employee.
I saw an interesting case, a Domino's case, where they had one of their employees that celebrated their birthday by taking a bath in the sink in the back. That went out to the whole public. They clearly could fire somebody that did that.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, that's an individualized act. It's not discussing a term or condition of employment. They are not rallying other employees to discuss terms and conditions of employment. So I think in that case, that employee could lawfully be terminated as well.
So let me go to the opposite side. I have an employee that says there are not enough models of color. And they're complaining about the company that there isn't enough diversity on the model front. Is that something?
That's a closer call. What it might depend on is if that is an issue that's being discussed in the workplace among employees, and then employees take it to Facebook or Twitter, and there's some dialogue between employees or a call to action for employees, then it probably is considered protected concerted activity.
Okay, so give me an example of something that absolutely would fall in protected activity.
Well, wage and hour is a big issue in the fashion industry and a lot of industries, obviously. If an employee thought that they were working overtime but not getting paid for it, and they took to Facebook and rallied other employees of the company to talk about their experiences with overtime, that's protected concerted activity, and that employee should not be fired.
Great advice, Mike. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony.
Thank you for joining us for another edition of Fashion Council.